Hey guys, welcome back to Oxygen Not Included, Klei's amazing space colony simulator extraordinaire. My name is Twitchi and we're on the LV426A cluster of asteroids where we've been surviving for the past 336 cycles with a whole bunch of duplicants. Last time we went to this brand new radiation filled rock to try and find ourselves some thimble reefs so we can start making environmental suits to keep our duplicants happy. We found mysteries that need to be unlocked, but then I discovered a problem. Over here on our first asteroid, Turanu, this is where we have the most duplicants, 5 out of 8, 4 out of 8. Excuse me, what just happened? I bet someone's gone inside of this over here. View interior. Yeah, there we go. All right, Hicks is in there. Okay, well, anyway, it is the most populated of the rocks, and the problem is, we are not doing very well for oxygen at all. We've got a lot of guys breathing and expelling some carbon dioxide, and most of the carbon dioxide is either being turned into polluted water or pumped directly up into our rockets over here. And so we need to upgrade our water system over here, our oxygen system, water to oxygen system that we have over here. We have a grand total of 2 different water forms. We've got a polluted water vent over here being cleaned up and also sent off to the rest of the base. And also down below, we have a salt water vent. It's currently dormant, but the liquid pump down below has an awful lot of water to get through. And full pipes, of course, and full pipes. The standard build to go with here is something called a Rodriguez, something that was built by a man called Rodriguez. Man? Player? I don't know, actually, to be honest. A player called Rodriguez, given to Francis John to show off on his YouTube channel, and then we've all decided to pick it up and run with it. We can build one of these here, but we're going to have to make a few changes. For starters, the oxygen producers are in the wrong place. We need to move them, this one here, for instance, up to this position. It's going to take a little bit of shuffling around, and I want to try and keep the oxygen flow going throughout this whole process. So, stick with me. We'll see how it goes. I think I'm going to be able to do it, but the first thing we're going to have to do is move this, and we want to get some airflow tiles up here instead. Everyone's always just one job away. What was Ash doing? They're all doing stuff over here. I mean, I suppose getting more power is quite important. Barely 2 minutes in, I've already got the alarms going. We need to just move all of this rubbish that needs picking up. Like, look at it all. It's all just everywhere. I'm not that fussed by the dirt down here, to be honest, but what I am fussed by is all the stuff that's in here. We can't quite get the brine out of here. Oh, it's brine, not salt water. That's okay, because we're going to start building ourselves a bottle emptier. Maybe 2 of them. 1 for salt water, 1 for brine. All right. Half a cycle of full panic's probably good enough for now. We got a lot tidied up, actually. Okay, first major scary part is going to come from the fact that we need to deal with this polluted oxygen here. Should we let it out first, or should we just put it into the system and let it deal with it? I think we're just going to put it into the system and let it deal with it. We need to deconstruct this door. You know what? I'm not even going to put this tile here. It'll be fine. It will be fine. I've just been reminded about this liquid pump because the new guy, Eric, where are you? Wow, right? Why is randomers all the way up to 69%? Stress. Oh, no. Anyway, Eric has just given us a scolding warning, which means he was down here trying to fix some stuff. We're going to destroy this pump, and we need to go back over to your keel, because from the new place, from Shiruby, Hicks brought down a whole bunch of stuff, and what we want in particular, if we come into here, gold amalgam, which doesn't seem to be able to get moved out of this place. There it is, 560 kilograms of it. How do we get this out of here? Okay, so I've given them all a big old sweep errand of 9. Let's go back out to your kill and see if we can't get it dumped down into one of these. How about this? This is the one I used last time, right? Let's try again. Okay, I decided to try the conveyor loader first, actually. We've got the gold amalgam highlighted. I don't think we've got anything else. I'm just going to turn that one off. Okay, gold amalgam only. Go. Yeah, we got people doing it. Beautiful, beautiful. Okay, so with that, we've got some gold amalgam being passed into here, which should hopefully be immediately being passed through. We go over to Turano over here, and up this way, yeah, gold amalgam being dropped. Beautiful, beautiful. So now we should be able to drop this right here. That's all the gold amalgam, but we'll hopefully be able to keep this here. The reason that I want gold amalgam become clear when it's built, I think I'm going to have to wait for it to be built. Okay, randomers took some hits for the team there, but if we have a look at the liquid pump, it doesn't melt to 125 degrees, which actually is more than we've got anywhere around here. So this should now just keep turning over, hopefully. Oh, randomers. Oh, man. Let's put you in triage. Okay, randomers is there. He's receiving care, so he should be okay. I'm also going to give a small sweep order. I say small. Let's just start getting the whole asteroid's worth of stuff, though, right? Okay, that's a lot of stuff to pick up. It should keep them busy for some time over here. All right, let's leave them to. I mean, already they're going around and popping things in here. We're just gonna knock stuff down to the bottom of this hole. It's all gonna stay there. It's gonna be horrific on the decor, but we're just gonna have to live with that. Okay, back over to Tyranno. No, we were just on Tyranno. Yakil. I always feel like Tyranno and Yakil's names are like back to front, but yeah. Body temperature, what's going on here? It's cold, but we are pumping heat around. Okay, we must be getting too much cold water coming out of this way. Yeah, indeed, this is trying to pump up as hot as it can and still not doing it. Okay, I see what's going on here. It's trying though, it's trying. See if we can't induce a bit more warming by some extra loops here. Okay, our extension did leave with a little bit of a gap in the line here, but I've come along and put down a bit of a liquid pipe over here so that when it passes over, let's hold on a second. Once this gap comes underneath these liquid pipes here, you can see that it's stealing some of the water from there to fill it up. Now, hopefully this had been warmed up by the space heater. Unfortunately, it's not quite doing its job as advertised, and we are getting some rather cool little bits of water coming through here. 12 degrees. That's going to bring down the temperature pretty severely when we get started, but obviously the temperature in and amongst this lot here. F3, there we go. That's the button I was looking for. It's 30 degrees down there. It's 30 degrees. We should be fine. Anyway, oxygen system or something? Okay, to get the next bit in, we're going to have to get rid of this hydrogen generator. It's in the way, it really is. We can't put down more than one airflow tile, and I need to put down two to put another electrolyzer on top of. So we're building ourselves a little bit of a gas tank down below. I've never heard of anything going wrong with storing tons and tons of hydrogen around. Hopefully it's not going to be in the way, though. That's my big concern, is whether me putting stuff down here is going to be in the way of me building stuff, because there's nothing worse than doing something to think you're fixing, and then actually all you've done is destroy. Wow, it's taken Bishop an awful long time to build this. Oh, and downtime is called. We did quite a bit during one day. We got two electrolyzers set up, ripped down a lot of the old stuff, got some hydrogen on storage underway. Yeah, this is good. This is going well. How about these guys? How big is the pile of stuff? Oh no, we put bleach stone down there. That might not be great. I mean, we've got a fairly dense oxygen atmosphere above it, so hopefully this will just fill up with chlorine, and then it will be a sterile environment. That's not a problem, right? Oh, I don't know when they got done, but thankfully these two bottle emptiers down here got done. So we're going to set one as salt water, one as brine sweep only, and one as salt water sweep only. And that should allow everything drained down here, where it can be quite easily processed by our desalinator over here. Where are they putting the ice? This kind of worries me. What worries me more is always the temperature of ice. So we seem to be doing okay, minus 6.2. Quite often it will get down to being ridiculously warm. Where is he going? Picking up more ice. I mean, like, cool, but where? Obviously, if the ice gets above 0 degrees, actually 3, because there's a bit of a grace period, like there's a buffer zone, if you will, activation energy, you might be tempted to call it. But once it gets to that temperature, it will melt and put water everywhere, and that's not what I like to see. And as we've already lost an entire degree from Jonesy just running back and forth, I don't feel like I'm entirely loving his plan. I'm liking where this is actually going though. Dump it into the automatic dispenser and all of that gets dropped into here, where it hopefully just melts almost instantly. There goes the ice. Let's watch the ice. Minus 4.7. Okay, coming up on 0 degrees, I'm more interested actually in what's going to happen to the actual water itself. We've got a whole bunch of polluted water around, and this ice is going to melt into other water. There it goes. Did you see that? It went up, it plopped up above, and then it came back down. Okay, that's cool. At 0 degrees exactly. Interesting. Okay, a small rearrangement outside, and we have got the electrolyzers up and running on this side, which means we can deconstruct this. I don't know whether people are going to be able to make the way through all the doors. We also kind of want to get rid of this ladder here. There's a lot of stuff that's just a little bit extraneous to purpose right now. Let's see if we can't tidy some of that up, including, like, look at these power lines. Well, I think in summary, we can say yes, they can go through both those doors and rip stuff down. That's cool. That's really cool. Also, we have not put some automation wire in place. We need to remember to do this. I almost guarantee that I'm going to forget, like, a power wire or an automation wire or something. That's why I got these doors on the outside. Normally, they're like, just seal these up. You don't need the... Yeah, no, I need to be able to get back in there because I'm a terrible player. I don't know how many days through we are now, but I'm starting to think this atmosphere sensor, two or three, we're not far, this atmosphere sensor is getting in the way. It's not really allowing as much oxygen to be passed through as was going previously. I mean, we did have the second pump running as well, But yeah, I mean, there was going to be some interruption, but I really was aiming for less interruption than this. Maybe we'll just cut this. Oh no, because then it's always off. Hang about. Above 100. Go. And the power ran out. Oh, great. Okay, that's the other pump up and running again. Got that output up. That's brilliant. That's exactly what we're trying to see here. Of course, eventually what we're going to be doing is separating the purpose of these two. This one's going to be only on hydrogen, and we're going to have a whole bunch down below on oxygen. Of course, we've got this little guy hidden back here, the anti-entropy thermal nullifier. We're going to be using that to chill down our oxygen, because this gets up to quite a warm temperature when it's running. Oh no, guys, the real life gardeners have turned up. There's noise everywhere. I'm just gonna get this done and then we'll come back. I might even dig this out here. This thermal anti, you know what, let's make that a priority and let's do a little time lapse. I think they've gone. It's quiet around here. So I've given Ash the ability, let's come up to the skills here, to be a plumber. Where are you, Ash? Brilliant, cool. Because I want to be able to empty out the pipes in the background here. We have managed to open up the anti-entropy thermo nullifier, which is good because we're going to have to start sticking the hydrogen somewhere very soon. But we are very close to having this all completely done. As you can see, we've got the gases beginning to sort themselves out. Down below, we have got some pipes hooked up. We're not going to have this running out of here. As you can see, the majority of the gases coming through here are just oxygen. In fact, as soon as Ash moves out of here and stops breathing carbon dioxide everywhere, that should end up with only pure oxygen coming out. So we'll put a little jump bridge here and maybe even cut this line here and send all that oxygen off to the base. We're then going to have a second oxygen line here. Both of those lines are actually going to come down across the thermal entry. Anti-entropy thermal nullifier. Bam, got it. Totally didn't have to read that. Run the pipes past here, up and then into the base. That'll probably be a better way. We're not trying to chill down too much, but if we have a look at the temperature overlay, as soon as I find out which button it is. Oh, this was it. Last time I was looking, we had 23 degrees here. It's obviously cooled down quite a bit more. Okay, we'll just keep an eye on it. We'll see what happens. Anyway, the pipes are empty. Pipes are nearly empty. We'll let that one blob go. Well, that was a surprising amount of water that fell out the bottom of that pipe. But okay, that should be fine. As soon as we get this mopped up and then get everything picked up, this should nearly be ready to go. Maybe we would like some sort of... Wait, automation's what I want. Maybe we want some sort of atmosphere sensor to here and here, and then we hook these up like so. And then we're going to take all of this hydrogen, hopefully put most of it into the anti-entropy thermo nullifier over here. The rest is going to go into a tank, and then we're going to set up a whole bunch of generators up here, hydrogen generators, to burn off the excess. Now, I've got a feeling there's going to be a whole lot of reworking. Like, look at this pipe. It comes all the way over here just to go back. I bet we could put another one here just to be better. This might set some water... I'm all right with that. I'm fine with that. Can we even get to the other side of this bioscale? Yeah, it's unreachable. I wonder if there's another way round. Saying that it's going to end up cold here is a bit of an underestimate. This is going to get down to, does it stay at minus 15 or does it get down deeper? I cannot remember. It might even get down to like minus 60 at some point. I don't know. I remember freezing a lot of different gases around this thing last time. So we're going to have to try and make it safe. Now, obviously, we've got some insulated tiles here, so I'm thinking that maybe we can just, like, run that up there like that. Obviously, it's not the winner right now because we need to put a bunch of pipes in, but that shouldn't be too difficult. Oh, there's a lot of stuff going on here. So I'm trying to move the oxygen out and around this way to try and get it back out to the base past the thermal and... The anti-entropy thermal nullifier. I'm also in the middle of moving this saltwater line just out of the way. Oh man, it's so in the way. Let's get it out of there. Okay, here goes the water. It's a bit sluggish, but then we are like quite low of temperature. Oh, we are warming it up at 1 degree, 2 degrees. Oh, this is good. We've now flooded it, so we're not going to be making any snow here today, it turns out. We are definitely going to have to embark on a secret hidden second phase of this. If we go around and have a look at some of these wires, we can see that we are very close to overloading them. Now, while this says 3,600 watts, I've literally never seen it get up that high. But I think we're going to have to start making a new power sector over here. I'm going to do it literally by having two of these together, then putting two batteries, and then running a line off of that. And I want to have that too wide. This is not the ideal placement for it. We need to move them forwards a bit. Let's start with the batteries. Okay, I reckon here and here is good. Obviously, this is going to end up getting powered by this one particular unit. I've got to wait for that autosave. Maybe I'll toy with turning that off one day, but not now. Not now. What do you mean forgot the blocks that the buildings need to stand on? No, that doesn't sound like me at all. Totally changed my mind. I was going to group them up in vertical twos, but look how much easier that is. Yeah, we're definitely doing that instead. OK, Okay, it took a little bit of creative reshuffling, reworking, and moving around, but we finally got gases going to two directions, one going up and out to our second base via the magic of the teleportation device over here. I'm still not sure how that actually is supposed to work. And then, of course, we've got this gas line here, literally just delivering to a bunch of vents that we have around the base. Oh, beautiful. Hopefully we'll get back into these nice blue colors at some point very soon. Oh, we seem to have developed... Sorry, let me set the scene here. Here is your kill, the place where we're at. I was noticing that we got a little bit of starvation warnings over here. He's still giving the starvation warning, actually. I wasn't expecting that. Okay, he's picking up food as we speak, question mark? No, we've not got enough food, maybe? Okay, I'm seeing not enough food at the moment. We'll send some food back from Yakil. But we've got an outhouse that has been ignored for so long. I've turned it up to a 9 now, and I think we're going to have to do something pretty drastic. We're going to have to kill these guys because, oh my gosh, we can't have this many mobs running around. Like, maybe if we were that pressed for oxygen and we could put up some air scrubbers and... I mean, that's kind of what is going on anyway. But let's get rid of them. We don't like them. Decor overlayer, what are they doing? Outfits bad. Doesn't look like mobs are actually contributing. Plus 10. Wait, they help? Oh well, it's too late now. Let's just send a bit of a bulk order of food. I've selected everything. Bunch of people are doing stuff. Let's put it on a 9 and wait. It's only half my calories. It's all right. All right, he found some food. How bad is... I mean, he's got 1,000 calories. He's all right. And to make it even more so, look at the food. We'll ask them to sweep it up and put it in their little sterile pit over here, which I believe is still on the edibles. Yes, brilliant. Okay, there goes the food. Should stay nice and safe in there, hopefully. Why are they all open container? All right, it doesn't matter. They just must not be rendering properly. But there we go. We've got food. All right, great. Back to building the power system here. Okay, I'm going to cut the power right there. That's where that's going to happen. I'm going to grab this conductive wire and we are going to pump it through to that. That should help. And we're also going to cut this here. That should also help, I hope. Okay, so we're at the point where we can do a little bit of streamlining. This little pump up here, this gas filter in specifically, we don't need that. Let's just get rid of that and let's bring this gas line down here. And of course, just to be sure, we're going to make sure... Can I have that, please? Thank you. We're just going to cut that there as well. A whole bunch of stuff is going to get destroyed here, like this on this side, that's on that side. Beautiful. We should be able to now not have any power running up there. So of course, let's... Oh no, we can't take those wires out. Let's be smarter about it. Okay, I think we got it. We've got some very dangerous looking power spikes there. Maybe we'll be able to do something about that at some point. I wouldn't count on it though. Down here, everything seems to be working fine. This is just to get rid of the water. I mean, it'd be nice if we could use this to run some other stuff, right? How about we disconnect... Oh, wrong button. I pressed the Z, not an X. How about we disconnect this one here? Drop maybe a little bit of extra power over this way, and then maybe we can use this line here. I don't know what it's going to come in at the power as. I mean, it's quite low. Hopefully when these get connected, it will stay low. Then we could use them to power this gas pump up here instead. That would be cool. Major issues there. Well, no, let's be honest. Minor issues there. When this turns back on, it will just pick those up. We'll do a little bit of damage to our hydrogen pumps over here, but that should be okay. We can repair this stuff, right? Cobalt. Yeah, maybe. Okay, so the area got cleaned out. We do have a little bit of carbon dioxide in there. We're gonna see what happens. And oxygen. Well, whatever. We're gonna see what happens when it goes through these generators here. I've got a feeling it's gonna have to be the... Oh no, it does get picked up by that. Wrong element damage. Well, it's not much. 80 kilograms. We got that lying around, right? I mean, sort of. There's 50. Okay, max load, 1920 out of 2000. Max load, 1560 out of 2000. I think it took some doing, but I think we got it. Let's put in some insulated tiles now. We did say that was going to be important. We want this coming down here and probably just seal this in. Just seal it in. It'd be nice to flood fill this with hydrogen, actually. Let all the other gases out. Wait. Can we do that? Can we do that? I don't think we can, actually. Not with this particular setup. Maybe if we cancel this, let's just leave two gaps now for people to walk through. We'll deconstruct that and deconstruct this one. F7, here's the hydrogen. We could make it go for just a little bit more of a journey and then put a gas vent right there. It will float up and fill this area and hopefully force all the gases out down below. That's my plan. Let's see if it works. Okay, it's already started. We've got a little bit of hydrogen on the way in there. Oh, we need to sort out this flow direction. We are going to lose almost all the hydrogen that comes through here just to begin with, just to fill this area up. I was going to put a hole on this side, as I previously explained to you, to let all the gases out. But obviously, the heavier gases like to come bottom right. So we'll put an airflow tile down here instead and let all the gases out that way. Nighttime got cold, so I've called a little bit of alert abuse. Man, I couldn't get that sentence out for some reason. So we're going to just let all the hydrogen pile up the top here. It's not quite what we wanted, but it's what we've got. Okay, we're technically there now, and this one keeps wanting to fill up with either hydrogen or polluted oxygen. It'll make its mind up eventually, but we've got a whole bunch of stuff in here that I want to get rid of. So let's try and get all that out of there before we do anything more drastic. How did you just pick it up through the wall? I'm fine with it, but how? Okay, the whole area is dug out, but there is a fast way in and out. I'm wondering what would happen if I just went and see what happens with that, right? Other stuff is closer. Let's get rid of that. I didn't mean to pull up their schedule. Let's get rid of all of this and see if we can't entice them to the correct place. Probably would help if I built a way in and out. That might make things a little easier for them. The answer is very much yes. Awesome. Okay, I think we've got all the stuff with that one, but of course there is more to what's in here than just what will go inside the solid storage. Somewhere, what is this, brine? We've got this brine pool here. Let's get people moving that one as well. And also we've got a whole bunch of ice, and that belongs up in this one. All right, we did it. Let's just seal this up now. All right, good, we done. Oh, that's beautiful. Constant oxygen flow, I mean, close enough. Over on Taranu, the other rock that we've got going here, we can see that this one is backed up already towards the gas masks. That's cool. The oxygen is about halfway up to pressure over here. Okay, it's going to take a little while for this to fill up completely, though it looks like it might actually do it at some point. I've just noticed, and I'm sure you guys have watched for a little while, the bishop is slowly having a bit of a major meltdown. I didn't notice it to begin with, but yeah, it really is. Let's go and have a look at his skills. Bishop, my friend, what is going on? You've got plenty of morale. What's stressing you out, my friend? So I notice he does this job a lot. Maybe this is the place that does it. Low oxygen, 10% per cycle. Let's refresh that little thing there. Yeah, maybe this is part of what's doing him a bad. I mean, it's still dropping. There must be something else. Gonna pop a couple of hanging pots in, because I've just noticed, this fry area over here, not looking particularly good. But Bishop is the man we're following. What's wrong with it? Still going down. I don't know, we're just gonna assume that he's getting better. He's got 10% better in that time, so yay. But once again, what was supposed to be a small half segment of the episode has blown up to become the entire episode. But we've gone and got ourselves a robust oxygen setup going now. We take water from both this polluted water vent up here and the salt water vent down below, give them a little bit of a clean up, and then pump them into these electrolyzers. They get out gas, and we have got a bit of a natural filtering mechanism where the hydrogen floats up and over and the oxygen sinks down below. This enables us to pump out pipes full of those specific gases without needing any filtration, not taking any more power. Wonderful, isn't it? This situation does create a little bit of temperature. As you can see here, 26 degrees is something that would be far too hot to just pump in straight away. So we pass it over the anti-entropy thermal nullifier. Whoa, managed to get that in one go this time. And this brings out oxygen somewhere about 3 degrees. That's maybe a little bit too cold, but we just need to up the through rate to make that work. Over on Taranu, I do believe the oxygen is starting to get much higher pressure now. It might even be to the point where we're starting to, yes, see some gas pressure over, some gas vent over pressure. That's pretty good. It should mean that this starts backing up now. And I suppose one of the things we could do to improve this system is give some sort of bleed over between the two pipes here, but that's going to be a problem for another day, because I have a run out of time. I want to say thank you very much for joining me for this adventure, ladies and gentlemen. I will see you next time, where hopefully we get to go and have a look at Cherubi, this little crashed satellite here. We've got ourselves a rocket landing platform, and we should be able to come over. We've got some food being made, and we've got a trailblazer to rip apart for materials, but I will see you then when we're gonna do that. Bye.